Hello everyone, here I am telling you the pathogenesis of rheumatic fever. Rheumatic fever is usually a disease of children, so you can see this is a person. These are the tonsils of the person. The person got tonsillitis or pharyngitis by a bacteria. The name of the bacteria is group A streptococcus bacteria. So what is happening? The body is forming antibodies against the bacteria. These antibodies are coming and removing the bacteria, destroying the bacteria. So the rheumatic fever is not caused by the bacteria. What is the problem? The problem is that whatever antigen present on this bacteria, the similar antigen is present on human five organs. What are the human five organs? The two vitals, brain, heart, skin. Below the skin, it's subcutaneous tissue, and below that, joints. So these are the five organs on which the similar antigen is present. So basically, these antibodies, which are actually formed for the bacteria, they will cross-react with these five organs, causing five diseases in five organs, damaging the five organs. So the five diseases are: in the heart, it's carditis; in the brain, it's chorea; in the skin, it's erythema marginatum; in the subcutaneous tissue, it's nodules; and in the joints, it's migratory polyarthritis. The five diseases together known as rheumatic fever. So rheumatic fever is not caused by bacteria. It's an autoimmune disease, and the mechanism is known as molecular mimicry and cross-reactivity. Thank you.